think so. I'm pretty full.
Cool.
It would dessert.
Thank you.
Adeline's 90th birthday, I believe, was yesterday. And she told me if she ever gets to be 90, she's going to milk that night. And guess what? Tonight's her night. And if she can't, Kathleen's going. What we wanted to do, first of all, is have all of Granny's children stand up so that everybody kind of knew we get a bunch of families together. So, Mom, Dad, if everybody in our family will stand up.
You mean the kids, too?
Yeah, the kids, too.
Stand up.
You don't sign me, wrong family.
Everybody up, Brandon. Okay, now, the side family. Okay, thanks, and Uncle Aunt Mary and Uncle Wilbur's family. Good, thanks. At this time, we're going to have the little kids sing. I believe Dawn's in charge of this.
All the great-grandchildren.
Great-grandchildren.
Take this one with you. Take this one with you. Take this one with you. she walks a long walk. She gets a little song.
Thank you.
kind of are so thought. We like to, this is probably our only chance to talk to everybody, and we would really like to thank you for all being here to in honor of Mom's birthday today. Or I guess we would say, in our community, everyone says Granny. And so we just thank you, and our Canadian relatives, we just thank you very much for taking this time out and coming over today and spending time with us. Her birthday, Mom's birthday, was yesterday, August 10th. And like I said, she's referred to pretty well into the community as Granny. And I don't know where that name started. I guess it's possibly because of the grandkids having a grandma besides, and so they wouldn't get mixed up, you know. The others are grandma, and she is just Granny. So, and I'd like to mention a few things to reminisce some, a few things of her past life, of, you know, of her beginning in Canada. And it's only really going to be really brief, because a lot of you could mention it a lot clearer than what I even know. So it's really brief. Just that Granny quit school at the age of 13. Now, a lot of you children, sometimes I'm not playing already, but a lot of you children, and she quit school at the age of 13. She didn't go to school anymore. And she got as far as sixth grade. And then she had to work out. She worked at home also and worked out for her folks, and worked at the home of other families, and babysitting and so on. And also worked at home in the gardens, and their gardens were bigger than ours, much bigger. You know, their gardens were fields. They weren't little gardens like what we have. I was over there, I didn't even think I was going to say this, but I was over there, I can recall being over there at a small age when they had a whole field of turnips. And remember Stan, right behind the barn? And they hoed them fields by hand. Most people that are over there know that, you know. And her activities, young folks got to go away every night of the week. And they went away, one night a week. And they went to other young people's homes, the church, and so on. But possibly one night a week. And they went with these, not four wheel cars, but these four-legged cars, you know. Trotted along, and a buggy. Now, Grandma and Grandpa Gingerich, that some of the others here too, came over from Canada in March 1922, and then Granny came over in October in 1926, and how it happened, our grandpa, my dad, some of you's grandpa, my dad, came over after her, 4 years after his folks had moved over here. That would be Uncle Andrew's parents. They came over in 1926. Okay, 1922. And then my dad went back over and brought Grandma over. They got a visa, and she was able to work over here. And Clarence Moyer, that would be
the rest of the family that are here, and Mabel, Clarence came over, and Clarence and Herb came over that same year in November, the next month, about a month later. And by the way, you know, if Clarence and Grandma and Granny wouldn't have came over, I guess we wouldn't have a reunion here today. So, and I can recall we'd go over about once a year, and there was a one time that we didn't get over for 4 years. I remember that. Went over about once a year, and the ride was long. It's about, what, 5 hour drive now? And we didn't have these highways, and it took, you start out about 4 o'clock in the morning, it'd be dark when you got there. It was a